What up, Smart Rapper Gang? You probably release music and you get upset when nobody listens to it because you know it's great and you put a lot of hard work, sweat, energy, sometimes tears into your music. Trust me, I've been there, released it and nobody listens, and it might be one of the worst feelings ever. In this video, I'm gonna help you make it as a music artist because I'm gonna show you what it actually takes to make it and become successful as a music artist. You're gonna completely understand by the time this video is over. So make sure you watch to the end. First off, you should already have a plan to market your music as soon as a song comes out. That's common sense, and I've talked about that at least 50 times on this channel. But what I often don't talk about is what happens if you do have a plan and the plan messes up. Or even worse, what if the whole plan and the whole strategy have to completely change because something happened? You had put all these plans together, then you release your song, and then, this isn't gonna work. In marketing, sometimes something happens where your whole plan just crumbles and you have to make an alternative plan. Let me explain a quick story right now of what happened that screwed up my entire singles marketing plan and strategy that I had planned for like probably 4 to 6 months, and what I'm doing to fix it that you can learn from. So I uploaded a lyric video for my new single, Spray. It's just a lyric video. Here's the thing though, it's the first single that I've released since 2017 because I was building Smart Rapper for you guys and getting everything growing. And it got age restricted. By 2,000 views, it was age restricted. First day, it was age restricted. Why is this bad? Well, this means that no one can watch the video without logging into YouTube and then verifying that they're 18 years or older. So even if you're logged in, you have to verify you're 18. So think about this, when it's posted to major sites like, let's say Hot New Hip Hop or This Is 50 or, you know, any of the big sites, when somebody clicks it, if they're not logged into their YouTube, they're not gonna, it says, please log into YouTube. You're not gonna log into YouTube, watch a video. You're just gonna move to the next thing, right? So we lose like 90% of people who aren't already logged in to their YouTube on their phone or wherever they watch, right? It's just not worth promoting that strategy to change. Because people can't share it freely if that's the process. It's just gonna bottleneck it. People wanna click and watch. When this happened, it ruined all of my plans. We had to push everything back a whole month and shoot a whole new music video that would not get flagged. Also, for anybody asking, where's the microphone contest? Well, this is part of the problem. I can't do the contest until the right video's out. See, now most people, especially old me, would have been just angry and upset or just given up and been pissed, like, screw this YouTube, what are we gonna do? Instead, I immediately pivoted and used this issue as a marketing strategy to use it for controversy to help it spread my new video even further. Now, basically, I'm taking the problem that happened and I'm flipping it upside down, and I'm using the problem against itself to create controversy. And by the way, if you're not watching the reality show on the Rob Level channel, you really need to, because it shows when we found out this happened and what we're doing to fix it and how we shoot the video and how we go through the whole process of fixing everything and making it all happen. And this show is really for upcoming artists just like you, because I'm showing you my process, the things I'm going through that you are probably gonna have to go through one day. That's why that show is amazing. You should definitely check it out. I'll put a link below for you. It's on my Rob Level channel. But you can see this whole thing happen, right? We're all messed up and how we fix it. You should really check it out. So we spent the last week planning, shooting, organizing, and putting together this new video that we had to. We even had to fly the guy out who was on the song. We had to fly him out. Like, oh, bro, I can get your ticket right now. Everything, all this crazy stuff. And I'll make another video on that that you're gonna learn a lot from too. But we needed a new video. We had to. In order to even promote and start the year off, we needed a new video, okay? And what's funny is that really, YouTube flagged it for age restriction because it had too much titty in it, okay? There was too much boob inside of the video. So because they flagged it for too much titty, we decided to have protesters protest against our video. And all those protesters were also angry that there was too much titty inside of the video. So we're using the protesters as a way to create controversy. So we hired a bunch of people to be in the video that are protesting the lyric video. And we're also using shots of the protesters and everything else like that to spin it to media as if there's protest happening. Obviously, it's a joke, but it's still a good headline, and it's funny, and it's fun to watch. And we're also gonna take the saying, too much titty, and make that a meme, which we already did. We already had a bunch of big meme pages that thought it was hysterical, and they already made a bunch of memes that they're gonna start posting after the new video releases to make people start saying too much titty. And when people try to figure out where it came from, it's all gonna lead back to the original lyric video that's age-restricted. And everybody wants to see the original video, because why? Because they wanna know if it was too much titty, and they wanna cast their vote, and they wanna have their opinion on if it was or not. And what's great is the opinions are generally like, it's like 80% say it wasn't, and then 20% say it was too much, but that's okay, because that creates what? More conversation, which means the song spreads more. See, we flipped it on its head. Like, I'm actually happy that this happened. Otherwise, it would have just been us pushing a lyric video that was a great lyric video that took a couple weeks to make. But now it's like, now we have a lyric video that people want to see, And we have a music video. Our new music video has me on a talk show, has me as a newscaster, and has us in front of the writers and outside, like interviewing the writers and stuff like that. It's really cool. And because it's based on the lyric video, anybody who ever watches the music video, which is gonna have tons of marketing behind it, will then want to also watch the lyric video. And right now, the single with no promotion is already at over 40,000 streams on Spotify, and it's moving. And even the age restricted videos, like at like 8,000 views. And we're not even promoting it yet because we wait and it's still moving. The point of this video in general, obviously I'm promoting the other thing, but I'm just using it as an example of what I'm doing so you could be updated on this, and I hope you understand this. But sometimes you have to take the bad and turn it to the light, okay? Like, not everything's just bad. Some people just be like, this sucks. Well, instead we took it and we made it good. We flipped it, okay? And you do the same thing with a lot of circumstances. You just have to think outside the box like that. Don't let something that appears to be an obstacle slow you down. Use it to push yourself further. Kind of like if somebody talks shit about you, don't be sad about yourself. Use them shit talking as fuel to be like, fuck you, I'm gonna show you, bitch. Now this may seem complicated, but you're an artist, you're supposed to be creative, you're supposed to be doing this stuff, you're not just making music. If you're a creative and you're actually an artist, you're creative on everything, not just music, okay? You've probably had to find workarounds like this your whole life to succeed, whether you believe it or realize it or not. And this is probably nothing new, but a new way of thinking that is going to help you succeed. And I want to instill that in you, okay? As I always do. Inspiration, motivation, and helping you believe in yourself and take the bad and turn it into good, okay? Because we did it. I just did this. I had to do this last week. I just did this. That's why I'm conveying it. I'm giving it to you. Like, don't let something slow you down. Be like, okay, next move. What's the next thing? What can I do with this? If you want to see the lyric video and see that what got flagged for too much titty, you can check it out. I'll put a link below for you in the description as well as the top comment. And when the music video comes out, you guys really check that out. You're really gonna like it. I'm also gonna show you guys how I'm doing the promotional push and the angles of getting people to talk about the controversy of this song and how we did the writers and stuff like that. It's very interesting. I'm actually very happy that it happened. There was a kid that was like, yeah, I'm the one who flagged it, you bitch, blah, blah, blah. And I was thinking, I was like, man, you don't even realize how much he actually helped me. I'm like, you idiot, it's cool. See, like, just take the haters, like, the haters are fuel. They don't even realize it, man. Keep hustling, gang. I'll see you at the top. Hit me a like, hit me a comment, hit me a subscribe, and you know what time it is, I'm bringing it back.
I got this right here, man. It's time for word of the day, new words, you can say new words for your rhymes and for your wordplay. By the time you leave this video, you'll be smarter than you was before.
This is so stupid. Word of the day today is circumvent. It means to get around something. Great example here is if I didn't circumvent all of the problems and the situations in my life, never would have been able to become successful. So circumvent your problems.